you can get the no makeup makeup look. And what I mean by that is I'm going to get rid of all the blemishes and all the flaws on my face and just get rid of those and just enhance my natural tones. So that's why the colors that I'm going to be using today may not exactly be the colors that you need to use, because you might have a different skin tone than what I do. But basically, when you're looking at having that kind of no makeup look, what you're wanting to look for is what your skin naturally does as it goes throughout the day. So when you get flushed or you blush, where is the color most pigmented on your cheeks? Like right now, I'm not wearing a lick of makeup, so you can see where I naturally get red, and my redness kind of goes down the bottom of my cheek. So I'm going to conceal that, but I'm going to choose a blush tone that's very similar to this. Same thing, I'm going to conceal the blueness that's in my eyelids, but I'm going to choose tones that are very natural to my skin tone. So hopefully that makes sense. I don't moisturize my face because since I'm going for a very minimal look, I want to just keep the skin looking as fresh as possible. Plus during the summer months, especially when it's warmer, I live in a very hot climate, the more products you have on the face, the more likely you are to become oily throughout the day as your skin heats up and reacts with what you put on. It is Primed and Poreless by Too Faced. And I'm really only putting the primer where I need it. I don't want to put the primer all over my face because I really don't need it all over the face. Highlighter to my cheeks. Now this step is completely optional, but it's definitely something that I like to do because I want the skin to look as perfect as possible. And so this is just going to help kind of hide any imperfections and put a little bit of glow on the cheek. And this is Benefits High Beam. And it looks like a nail polish. It comes out like this, so I just put a little bit on the back of my hand, because a little goes a long way. It's definitely buildable and you can get a very sparkly effect, but obviously I'm going for something that's more natural.
Put that in. White on the top of my cheekbone, right where I want to look a little bit more lit. I take a teensy bit and just go above my cupid's brow on the very high point of my nose and a little bit above my eyebrow. I'll go in with a foundation, and this is Makeup Forever Matte Velvet, and I'm number 25. And I'm just going to apply it to the areas that I have high pigmentation, meaning basically any colors where I appear more red, more yellow, more blue, that sort of thing. So definitely around my mouth and chin. And I'm just going to work this in with my fingers, because I want it to look, as natural as possible. And hopefully you can see that my skin is just starting to look much more even here at the end. This foundation does a pretty good job of covering most of the blemishes, but I'm probably going to go back and conceal those just a bit more. Take a little bit of foundation just under here. I'm really in a little bit of color, right? I prepped a little bit too much. On the nose. And it may seem like this takes a long time, but I promise it doesn't, because I'm using a very, very light hand, so you're not using very much product at all. Again, you want the center of your face to be the lightest part of your face, because it's just going to bring forward that part. To cover up my blemishes, I'm going to be taking, and I might have to change this, I'm going to try the Benefit Boing concealer, like industrial strength concealer, I think is what they call it. So the problem is I got it in medium, I'm certainly not medium. So I'm taking a little bit on the little art brush, and I'm just going to apply it to invisible spots. Actually doing a really nice job. I'm just going to take my finger and just kind of press it into the skin. For under my eye, I'm going to use my Garnier Anti-Dark Rollerball. I'm going to put this on the back of my hand, mixing Benefits Erase Paste with the Garnier to go underneath the eye. Make
making sure you get the outer part of the eye, because the more red and there's a red line, it's going to kind of droop, or purpley or blue, it's going to drag your eye down. I'm just going to go let it sit there for a second and blend out the edges. Again, up into the inner eye. And down into this area right here. Almost like in a triangle pattern. Take my ring finger and just blend that out ever so slightly. Be careful not to take off the product. A lot of people do that. Put some more on, rub it off, put more on. You don't really want to be messing with this eye area here. So just kind of let your concealer sit there for a second. If I still got too much on it, take a tissue and blot the excess off. Using my Tarte Flush Natural Cheek Stain. Again, you want to make sure you're using a shade that's going to go with the natural flush of your skin. So this one's perfect. It's called Flush. It's more, I know it looks extremely scary in the pot, but it goes on very sheer, and it's got that nice kind of red tone to it, which is, you know, pretty much what most people's blush, is going to be. It's going to be more of a reddish tone. And everywhere where I naturally would flush. So it's not necessarily about finding the apples of your cheek. It's just where you would naturally flush. So that way, when you do tend to get warm in the afternoon, it's not going to look silly. It won't mismatch. It'll match up perfectly. Now it's time to set everything with powder. So the first thing I'm going to set is my concealer, and anywhere I want to have a little bit illuminated by using the Benefit Powder Flash. Big fluffy brush, and just kind of press the powder on top lightly. You don't have to go back in for tons more product, but just basically start. It's kind of stippling. You're just going up and down, patting. I just find the less product that you have on your eye, you know, the less chance you have of anything sticking to a place you don't want it to stick to, like in the fine lines and things like that. The heavier concealers, the creamier ones, do a lot of the times, unless you use them light-handedly, which most people don't know how to use them, so they apply it too heavily, and then it gets cakey. But now I'm kind of rambling. I'm also just going to go under the areas that I want to highlight, so just around the mouth. I'm going to take a blush brush, angled blush brush. This one's from Sonia Kashuk. And go into my Smashbox Soft Lights Duo. A little bit here. Also going to add a little bit of, mineral veil, or any kind of setting powder, like a buffing brush. And get that in there, tap off any extra, and then just kind of press that to the areas that you know might get shiny throughout the day, and you might have a chance of slipping and sliding. A little bit of a bronzer. Preferably one with no shimmer, because of course if you're going for a natural look, naturally you won't have shimmer. But this is Photon by Bare Essentials, and it's just a nice kind of reddish little touch of life and dimension. So I'm going in the hollows of my cheeks and slightly up onto my cheekbones. Just the right here. And up into the temples. A little bit to the sides of my nose. Okay, and we're done for the face. Again, it normally doesn't take this long, and it wouldn't take you that long, but I'm just kind of going by step, more detailed. It's hard to tell with the mirror and the camera. It looks so different on camera than it does in real life, but anyways. First, I'm going to take Urban Decay Primer Potion in Eden. Get a little bit on the back of my hand, and really just a little bit. Get some on your fingertip, and just work that all the way from the lid to the brow. I like this because it's a matte, it's not got any shimmer to it, and it's more yellow based, so it just instantly kind of neutralizes any redness you have on your eyelids. I'm using my Smashbox palette, it's the Softbox, really, really fluffy brush. Almost looks like a face brush, and I'm taking the vanilla shade, which is the lightest, and a little bit of the peach, which is over the lid. Now this is matte color, because again, you want it to look natural. We don't have natural shimmer on her eyelids. Face brush by Studio Tools, I believe. And I'm going to go in with this nude color right here, which is like a couple shades darker than my natural skin tone. And I'm just going to ever so lightly, wherever my natural crease is, just go right there and a little bit above. I'm just kind of like a windshield wiper motion. Definitely don't want to see any harsh lines. This should just be looking like a natural shadow. Don't pull the color all the way down here, because it's just going to drag your eye down. You want to keep it up here. It's a small shader brush. Take that nude color and just run it right underneath the lashes on the bottom lash line, just to give it some added definition. A little bit of more of that white and just add it. I'm going to do my eyebrows, and I'm just going to take a little bit of powder. And I'm not going to do my whole eyebrows, I'm just going to kind of film in just a little bit. Because mine are pretty sparse and fair. This is the Smashbox Limitless Eyeliner Crayon in Java. And I'm just going to push that up into kind of near my waterline and where my upper lashes are at the roots. I'm just going to make it look a little bit thicker. Curl my lashes and apply some mascara. My new favorite mascara that I've been using is the Clinique Lower Lash Mascara. I actually just run it through the tips of my upper lash line and I do the bottom of my lower lash line. I love it. It doesn't flake, it doesn't budge, it doesn't move, and it just gives a real nice definition without being overly done. There you have it. There is my no makeup makeup tutorial. I hope you found this helpful. I hope that makes sense. I promise it does not take as long as that, but when I'm thinking about what I'm doing and trying to explain it to you, it just takes a little bit longer. But yeah, it's not overly made up. It doesn't look like I'm wearing makeup, but I definitely got rid of all my major flaws. So again, please comment, rate, subscribe, and I just appreciate it. I appreciate it so much. I appreciate the emails and the comments that I get from you guys. So just thank you. Thank you so much. It really makes my day. Bye.